Each Miss CUNY finalist got
45 seconds to answer the memorable
Miss Universe questions. If they'll go over time, they'll...
You're the hearing this now.
Hi, this is Juliana Forrest-Gobe. It's Showtime Miss CUNY, first Hall of Famer. And now, I'm taking the Miss Universe question challenge. Final question for Miss Universe 2017, Demelé Peters of South Africa. What quality in yourself are you most proud of, and how will make you apply that your time as Miss Universe? Ayan, the quality that I'm most proud of is probably my confidence. Kasi naniniwala ako na once you are confident, if you believe in yourself, you will be unstoppable. At ako ang naging buhay na testimonya na patotoo na hanggat naniniwala ako sa sarili ko, regardless kung ano yung mga negatibong naririnig ko sa paligid ko, ako'y mismo maniniwala sa sarili ko, ako lang ang magtitiwala sa sarili ko, at yun ang magiging susi ko para maging maabot ko yung tagumpay at maabot ko yung pinaka-atap-asap kong corona hanggang sa dulo ng laban. And I, thank you!
Hi mga kapamilya! I'm Magnat Centino, and I'm ready to take the challenge! What is the one lesson you learned as a child that still affects your life today? That you should not really have regrets on what you do, specifically on what you feel. Kasi I am a gay since when I was born already. That's why I said to my dad, who really opposes, na hindi kailangan lalaki ka. But then again, I fought for it. That's why who I am today is not only a lesson, but the thing that I have fought for. Thank you.
Hello mga kapamilya, my name is Miss Ria Nazareth and I am your ABS-CBN Miss Q&A It's Showtime third Hall of Famer and Grand Finalist. So I'll now be having the Miss Universe Q&A Challenge. Okay, so the final question for Miss Universe 2010, Jimena Navarrete of Mexico. In your opinion, what effect is unsupervised internet use having on today's youth? Well, this is very important, especially today that children can have an easy access with internet because we have these internet shops, these businesses that is around our community. I believe that children will be able to have access to these sites which is not suitable at their very young age. So they are accessing sites which affects their individualities. So I believe that it is very important for parents to have proper guidance and educate their children with regards to proper internet usage. For basically, the real use of internet is for educational purposes and to communicate with other people. Thank you!
Hi, I'm Lars Pacheco from Bukawi, Balacan, your Showtime's Grand Finalist.
The final question for Miss Universe 1973, Margie Moran of the Philippines. If you had $1 million, what would you do with it? For me, I would do with $1 million is to spend it with my family, have a bank account savings, and spare it to the poor. That's it. Because I believe that it's better to give than to receive. And if you give, and if you always give, always remember life is like an echo. What you give bounces back to you. And I thank you.
Hello, kapamilya. My name is Kemal Yehos Perlawan, and I am here taking the Miss Universe Question Challenge. The question I got is from Miss Universe 2013, Amelia Vega of Dominican Republic. The final question is, what is the most precious gift you have given to someone? I think the most precious gift that I've given to someone or to other people is not a material or a thing anymore. It's actually my care and love to other people. And also, because I always believe that our prime purpose in living is to love and help each other. If you cannot love them, at least you do not hurt them. That's what the Dalai Lama once quoted. So I always believe that if you give love to other people, it will bounce back to you. Just like what Mother Teresa once quoted, life is an echo. What you do to the world will always bounce back to you. And I thank you.
Hi, Madam People! This is Princess Kim Sanpilian. At andito po ako ngayon sa Miss Universe Question and Answer Challenge. My question is, final question for Miss Universe 2004, Jennifer Hawkins of Australia. what sex and time period would you choose to be born in? I definitely choose be a real woman. Why do I say so? Because yes, I am a gay right now and I feel to myself that I am a woman. But definitely, at this moment of time, I call myself as a transgender. A transgender that I know to myself, on my ethical outlook and inside my heart, I am also a part of humanity, and that's being a woman. Thank you.